Hey, it's Becky. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a simple yet customizable LED and battery circuit that's perfect for putting inside your next project. Let's get started. The most basic LED circuit can be made by sandwiching the legs around a coin cell battery. This is also a good way to identify the positive and negative legs of the LED, since it will only light up one way. That's because LEDs are diodes, which allow electricity to flow one way, but not the other. The positive side of the battery should be touching the positive side of the LED. And it's usually longer so that you can tell the difference. Put a little tape on it and you can enjoy the glow of this circuit for about a day before it gradually dies out. This is a super hacky way to add LEDs to projects, but it works if you need it to work for only a short amount of time, like for costumes or props. If you want to create a durable circuit, it's time to bust out that soldering iron, or soldering iron, depending on where you're from. In addition to your LEDs, you'll also need some resistors, some wire, some heat shrink tubing, a 3-cell battery holder, either AAA or AA, and a switch if your battery holder doesn't have one already. The specs of the LED, resistor, and battery pack must all work in concert to power the LED enough to light up, but not so much that it burns out. Here is a diagram of the basic circuit. Just as before, the LED positive side is connected to the battery's positive side, and likewise negative to negative. The current will flow from the battery through the resistor and LED and then back to the battery. The resistor and LED are connected in series, which means one after the other. In this way, the resistor limits the current flowing in the whole circuit, regardless of whether it comes before or after the LED in the circuit. And resistors aren't polarized like LEDs, so it doesn't matter which way around they go either. You can find LED resistor calculators online to help you figure out which resistor to use based on the specs of your LED and battery pack. But for these standard 10 millimeter LEDs and this 4.5 volt battery pack, any resistor value from about 100 to 300 ohms will work fine. I'll go into more detail about the calculation at the end of the video. To create the physical circuit, strip a bit of the insulation off ends of the battery holder's wires as well as both ends of two more wires of your desired length. Twist and tin the ends of the wires by adding a bit of solder. Tin both legs of the LED all the way up near the plastic lens. Then fuse one wire to each of the LED legs by holding them together and reheating the solder so it flows between them. If you didn't add so much during tinning, you may need to add a bit more solder to get the best connection. If you use two different colors of wire, you can trim the legs of the LED shorter without forgetting which one is which. Add some heat shrink tubing to insulate the bits of exposed metal so they don't short out inside your project. If you only have one color of wire, you can label the wires with a piece of tape. Then add more heat shrink tubing to cover the next set of joints. Since they won't have open ends, we need to remember to add the heat shrink tubing first. Trim the resistor leads and solder it to either one of the LED wires. Then connect the battery pack wires, positive to positive and negative to negative. You'll need to add one more piece of heat shrink tubing to whichever battery wire ends up connecting to the other side of the resistor. In case you also need to add a switch, it goes between the battery's power wire and the LED positive side. Power up the circuit to confirm the LED lights up, and you're ready to put this in your next project.
Let's talk about adding more LEDs. It's easy. Just duplicate the LED and resistor circuit and wire it in parallel with the first. It means that both LED positives are connected directly to the battery's positive, and likewise, both LED's negative leads are connected to the negative battery lead. It's important that each LED have its own resistor to account for slight variations in the LEDs that prevent them from behaving exactly the same as one another. A lot of folks think that they can shortcut this with one resistor for everything, and it might work for a little while, but eventually that circuit's gonna fail. This method of LEDs in parallel can work for upwards of 20 LEDs, or even more depending on your battery pack, but if it's your first time, I recommend sticking to 6 to 10 or fewer and keeping all the LEDs the same color. If you want to mix and match multiple colors in the same circuit, you're going to have to get more precise about which resistors you use, since they don't all have the same internal resistance. And the one that's easiest to flow through will get the most or all of the juice.
To assemble a circuit with multiple LEDs, you build the LED resistor assembly as before, but then join all the positive sides of the circuits together and all the negative sides together before connecting the battery pack. Your resistors can live at the base of the wires branching out or up next to the LED or anywhere in between, so long as you provide suitable insulation to prevent the wires from shorting out if they get tangled.
So why doesn't this LED coin cell battery circuit need a resistor? A coin cell battery is already the correct voltage, so that's taken care of, and then it happens to have enough internal resistance to prevent the LED from burning out. Coin cells contain lithium, though, and should be recycled with your e-waste, not thrown in the regular trash. What program are you using to make those diagrams? It's Tinkercad Circuits. It's great for this project because you can sketch out your circuit before you build it and even simulate it to make sure everything lights up. How do I calculate which resistor I'll need? Using Ohm's law, we'll solve for R, using what we know about the LED and the battery pack. On most sites that sell LEDs, you can find the data sheet and look up its forward voltage and its forward current. The battery pack has its cells wired in series, which in this case adds up each 1.5 volt cell together for a total of 4.5 volts. You can plug these values into one of the many online resistor calculators or do it out by hand. If you don't have the exact resistor, it's okay usually to go up to the next common value. If your LEDs are all the same color, you can compromise even further in the upwards direction, which will just dim the LEDs a little bit. If you have more questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below. I'd also love to find out what you're adding your LEDs to. Thanks so much for watching. Check out my cable splicing video for more soldering tips, and subscribe with the bell to be notified of my future uploads. You can also subscribe to my email newsletter and find me on social media. See you next time. This video was brought to you by my patrons on Patreon.